Hi everyone, welcome to Java Techie. While working with real-time code, we all may come across some common issue. That is, sometimes we are unable to recall the syntax. This is fact because we are developer. We never bother about syntax. We just focused on business, isn't it? But I want someone who will assist me in writing syntax so that I can improve my productivity. That's why Kudota came into picture. He is really very smart and intelligent, who will help us to autocomplete our code. Let's check Kudota official. So Kudota is one kind of plugin supported by any developer ID. It can be Eclipse or it can be IntelliJ. And this is artificial intelligence completion for your Java ID. It supports for Java, JavaScript and for few technology. Using Kudota, you can code faster and smarter using your ID, development ID. Let's understand few features provided by Kudota. So here we get to know Kudota will help us to AI completion for our code. So for that, Kudota is available as a plugin for your development ID. So next, Kudota will support full line AI autocomplete. So if you observe this syntax, input stream reader content equal, then once you enter space, it will suggest you what should be your next line. Similarly, it will help us to find relevant code example in a click. Suppose you are stuck in a middle, you can take help or this Kudota will assist you how you can write your code. Let's say something I am doing file IO example. I am using buffer reader, but I don't know how to use buffer reader. So in that case, if I will take help of Kudota, he will show me some dummy example how you can use your buffer reader. This is how Kudota will help us to find relevant code. Similarly, the code which will suggested by Kudota will be private for your ID. It won't be saved in your Kudota server. Okay, and these are the features. Code will be faster, prevent error and discover code. So let's do it in action. I am using IntelliJ here because I have Eclipse and already there I added bunch of plugins, so I don't want to mess with him. Let's use the IntelliJ. So this is what my IntelliJ. We need to go to the plugin section, Control Alt S, go to plugin. Here in top, you can search with name Kudota. Okay. So click on this install. Click on apply. Once your installation is completed, it will ask you to restart your ID. So click on this restart ID. Yes, I want to restart it. So after restart my ID, it is asking me to connect to complete the installation. So you need to add the login. So click on this. It will redirect you to the Kudota browser. So you can connect using GitHub and connect using Google. So let me connect with Google. It means I want to connect with my Gmail ID. Yes. Return to your ID to start using Kudota. So it's automatically connected with my Gmail. So let's go to the browser, close it. So we are good. Kudota is added to my development ID. So let's create a class, something like dummy class I'm going to create here. Test. So in this class, let me write the main method. So let's write the code for buffer reader. Okay. Buffer reader BR, or you can type the fully qualified name. So I just, after equal, I just enter space. So you can see the mark here, green color. This is suggested by the Kudota. So which one you want to use, just choose it. Suppose I want to use the third one. Now here you just give your dummy file name. Suppose you don't know how to use this buffer reader. So what you can do, instead of getting the suggestion from Codota, I can take the help of it. So here in end there is a example, or there is a link, get relevant example for buffer reader. Click enter. So let me zoom this. So it will suggest you how you can use your buffer reader. It will give one sample example. Using this you can write your code. First it will suggest me what should be my next line of code. If I don't know how to do that, then also it is helping me by giving one dummy example. Okay, so let's try for some other one instead of buffer reader. Let me remove this. Let me use the multithreading executor framework. Okay, executor service. If I just enter equal and space, it will suggest me again what are the equivalent code for it. So I want to use new cache thread pool. Again, if you don't know how to use it, just enter space and take the help of get relevant example for executor service. It will show you the example how you can use this executor framework, how to get the future object, how to map those value, everything you can get as a example with the help of Codota. So this is how Codota helps us to autocomplete our code, and this is what we tried with dummy POC where we used buffer reader and executor service. So while working in real time, we may face complex syntax. So in such case, the Codota will be more helpful. We no need to mug up the syntax. We can just take the help from the Codota. Okay. So this is, I added in IntelliJ. So this plugin is available for Eclipse as well. So go to this. You can type Codota for Eclipse. Okay. Then just go to it. You will find the Eclipse plugin. This is what the Codota for Eclipse. So if anyone using Eclipse, you can try with this, and I demonstrated here using IntelliJ. Yeah, that's it about this particular video, guys. Thanks for watching this video.